and welcome to Tesca Technologies Private Limited. I am Shivam Vijay. Today in this video, I am going to give a demo of lead tool dynamometer. The lead tool dynamometer is a revolutionary product in this market to observe the different forces applied on the lathe or job work at which the cutting, turning or any other tools are operated in the CNC, in the lathe machines and the different cutting and turning processes. So this lathe tool dynamometer is a very useful product to observe the appropriate force at which the turning should be in proper and accurate manner. So now we are going to demonstrate how this product works. So this is our complete product with the accessories are displayed in this video right now you are seeing. So this is the main instrument measurement system and this is the lead tool or the post tool at which it should be connected on the lathe machine, at which you can insert your tool whatever you want to use, either you want to in the turning or in the cutting process from the lathe. So both the tools can be inserted on this point and using this lathe tool, and these are some cables to connect the lathe tool with the measurement instrument or the display instrument. This is the USB cable, as this design is especially manufactured to observe appropriate forces by using this on the remote panel, or you can use it on with the PC at which all the data are provided with this. And this is the user manual in which all the details about how to operate the lathe tool dynamometer with the lathe machines are described, and how to calculate the resultant force at the appropriate point at the particular point while working with the lathe machine. So order code of this lathe machine is 19204894.37DA. So this is the lathe tool dynamometer. Now we are going to describe and give a demo at which we are just particularly use and describe how to connect the dynamometer and measurement instrument, and both the meter and instrument will be working with the display and as well as with the PC for data logging. So this instrument is basic purpose is to study the lathe tool dynamometer and determine the resultant force on the tool during the turning operation or in the cutting operation. Whatever we required, we can do this. And in this is the lathe tool dynamometer apparatus, and this is the force indicator in which all the three type of forces will be indicated on both the three axes. And tools, you can use the any of the HSS high speed steel tool with the tool holder, and in which this is the 25 mm diameter hole which can be easily used to assemble this lathe tool dynamometer on the tool post of any of the lathe machine. And by this you can insert your tool in this, and there are strain gauges which are especially designed to calculate the forces of three type of forces all when working the turning or the cutting process. Well, when the tool applies and meet the forces, this instrument will observe and the strain gauges inside this will works, and the resultant value will be displayed and calibrated accordingly on the force axis. So this complete setup works on the 230 volt 50 hertz AC mains supply, and the instrument comprises independent DC excitation supply for feeding strain gauge bridges and signal processing system for process and compute respective force value for direct independent display in the KGF unit. You can see the value in KGF units on the indicators. Now we are going to assemble to just give a small demo here. Right now we do not have the lathe machine, but we can see the values on the small forces value on this indicator by applying the forces from manual or the hand pressing, and you can see all the three different types of forces in this dynamometer display. So this is the backside of this measuring indicator. In this is the 230 volt power supply. This is required to control the lathe tool dynamometer, and you can connect the power cord here. Power cord will be supplied with the item as well. This is the on off switch here to on and off the complete circuitry, and this is the USB cable slot in which you have to insert the USB LPP LTT type, and by which you can connect and take the data on the computer as well. And these are the X, Y and Z connectors to connect the dynamometer tool approximately with the cables provided in this kit. This LED tool dynamometer has three connectors as well, also described X, Y, Z, all the axes. So you can connect X to X, Y to Y and Z to Z by using the connectors properly. Now we are going to connect the and assemble the complete machine, and then we turn on this. So you can see as I have connected all the cables by properly X, Y, Z axis, and now I will on the kit by turning on the on off button over here. First this will display a hello message in all the three displays. Now the value is 00 here. If you find some of the residual value due to any forces, you can use the tear button of each of the axes once. This will comes the value to 0. Now you can see as I applied force on this section of this dynamometer, you can observe the voltage and value in the displays. Right now I am applying vertical force, so this is showing X and Z which is applied on the tool. Now as I turn this to the horizontal, you can see the Y value in the minus and the Z value and the X value. All the three values can be measured and displayed in the KGF unit or the kilonewton force. So as I am applying force due to my hand, so this is very least force for this, but it can work up to the maximum amount of force required to turning and cutting a tool or the job required. Now we will see in the manual the working and the proper instruction to use the LED tool here are described. So forces on a single point in turning is described. Here Fx is the feed force or thrust force acting in a horizontal plane parallel to the axis of the work, X axis. And here is Fy, the Y force, the radial force also acting in the horizontal plane but along the radius of the workpiece, that is along the axis of the tool. Here the description also described the Y axis, which is the axis of the tool directions, and the Z axis is the cutting force acting in the vertical plane and is tangential to the work surface, also called as the tangential force, Z axis. The resultant force can be calculated by using this formula provided in this user manual also. So the resultant force is equals to square root of Fx square plus Fy square plus Fz square. The workpiece is fixed in a 3-jaw chuck with the sufficient overhauling. So this is the description of the tool, and the other instruction like the dynamometer cutting tool should be posed in the such a way the tip of the tool coincides with the lathe axis, and select the proper cutting speed and feed depth of the cut. After that you will get the, and you will, if you follow all the required information and required instruction, then you will get the appropriate force which is applied or the single point of the tool. You can also measure and observe all the different values in the table to check the all forces and to calculate the resultant forces on the one point of this. Now we are also described to give a short demo of how the data will be observed in the PC as well. Now here you can see in the PC, these are the softwares to connect the USB cable. This is the main display software at which you have to use this software. Inside this, all the installation file RMCD EXE is provided to control this. And in case the software is not work, this setup should also be installed. But the setup can be performed with these two folders only. Now, to install the driver, you can select any of the drivers which are compatible for your PC. By this, you can connect and install. I have already installed the 64-bit Windows for this my PC right now, and the user manuals for all the different values are provided. So this software is need to be run. Here you can see the screen setup is larger than the ratio of my PC. So this is right now not displaying in the complete full display, but when you use this PC with the compatible screen, this can be displayed on the full screen as well. Right now this is the complete display at which all the forces will be described in the graphical manner, and also in the value and data logging can be achieved using this. Now we will connect the cable for data logging of this. Now this is the USB cable which is provided with this, so this should be connected on the USB port that I was described earlier. So properly connect the USB cable in the USB port behind the Now this should be connected on the USB port of the PC also. Now you have to select the appropriate COM port from your device manager. The dynamometer will only work when you select the COM port 4. So if your COM port 4 is used in any other devices, you have to change the COM port for this device, and then you have to select the COM port 4. Here you can see my serial port is COM port 4 for this setup. You can go to properties, port settings, advanced. Here you can select the COM port 4 if the COM port 4 is not showing. And if the COM port 4 like this, the 5 is showing in use, you have to change the COM port 5, but the machine will work only on the COM port 4. Now we will turn off this and again start the. Here after installing the software, you will get the shortcut like this to completely on this. Now after using and completely installing the software and cable, connecting the cable, this panel COM port status will be turned green. Here you can see earlier it is not in the green. Now as I press start button provided here, and you can see the graph screens are now in running as the time versus load graph is started. Now as I apply forces on the tool by my finger or any of the hand, you can see the graphical values are also showing at the screen as well. Here you can see, observe the different graphical values on the screen as well, and the compatible graph of the all three axes and the consolidated graph is also described in this. So this is the graphical representation through the computer. All the values are defined and described in this. Now for saving the file or for print the setup, print this window, you can press Control Print and select any of the location and give any name. Let we see, we give LED tool dynamometer LTD sample. So all the constant forces will be saved to the display, or in the PDF form we can see the display here. LTD sample, the file is provided. So this is the graphical representation display. All the details are also provided here. So this is how you get the data logs, all the different values and the different other values. And when you do not require to maintain the record, just stop the process and reset all the data to start the another process as well. Now close this. So this is all about this LED tool dynamometer cum indicator or this tool, and you can use this as I described in this demo. And while working with this kit, if you find any difficulties, you can contact to Tesca Technologies Private Limited for all type of supports. Thank you.